Can you see me live, sir, now? Hello?
I'm just trying to figure out. Hang on for a moment. Yes, I can see you live. Now I need to figure out how do I add myself to
Please,
this.
sir, I've sent you already to join me. Yes, I am trying to join you. I'm adding you, sir. You'll get a. I think you can add
Yep,
me.
I got your join. Says join.
Join, please join, sir. I'm waiting for you.
You must rotate your phone to join.
You must, yeah, you should keep it vertical, sir. I mean,
Okay.
yeah, you shouldn't shift your phone, sir.
I guess I can see you now.
Thank you, sir. It's perfect.
Please
Perfect. I'm saying this is not live. Live is at 5 o'clock. We have Biplab Gupte, who is a media person. He's a wonderful coach. Above all, he's going to talk to us about positivity, how to be positive during this pandemic time. And he has been a mentor for many people. He has been a coach for many people, and one of the person is me. So we'll be going live in some more time. We are just doing audio and video, so it's going to be a wonderful show. You can ask questions to him on anything, sir.
Yes.
Yeah, you can, sir. Do you get any?
I don't. I'm okay now.
Okay, sir. But आप disconnect होते ही रहे, sir. When
I
your
don't know.
sir, when any call or anything comes, no, sir, don't attend it. Otherwise, you'll get disconnected.
Please.
There is
There is
an
an
option
option
now.
now.
So you're getting echo. That's because of the we're in the phone call. I'll end the call. We are in the line now. So is everything fine, sir? You can.
I can hear you now, but very.
Very what? Very less?
No, no, I can hear you now. Perfectly.
Perfect. Yeah.
Yes.
So yeah. Everything is fine, sir. You don't have echo voice or anything, no, sir.
Not at all. Not at all.
Sir, it's almost 5, sir. Should we
Five.
start live
Yes.
now, or we'll take a
Yes.
break and start?
No,
How
no,
is
we
it?
can go ahead. Not a problem. We should, in fact, start.
Perfect, sir. Perfect, sir. Sir, thank you, sir. First of all, I wanted to introduce Biplab Gupte. He is a media person. He is into writing. He's into many things. I've been talking about him, and above all, he's my coach also. He's my mentor also. And one thing about sir is that he's always, I mean, if you go and tell him the very serious situation, you're stuck and you call him, sir, 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 aise ho gaya, sir, something's up, sir. But he's always cool. Nahin, don't relax. Ho jayega, kyun? And he has a solution for everything. Everything, trust me, everything. I worked with him for almost 4 to 5 years. And I've learned a lot of leadership qualities from him. I've learned positivity. I've learned how to calm down and many things. Today, I feel very honored to talk to him. So thank you, sir. Thank you for coming to my show. Sir, tell me first thing, sir. How are you dealing with this pandemic situation? How are you keeping yourself positive, sir?
I'm staying at home. My wife is cooking great dishes for me whenever she manages time from her work schedule. Her work from home is continuously on, so she manages some time in between, and I get some dishes to eat in between. That's source number one for positivity. And secondly, there are lots of books that I have which I haven't finished, so I'm reading them. I'm watching television. And as far as the mind is concerned, how to stay positive in a scenario like this? Actually, I've been reading about this pandemic quite a bit, and I realized that it's not as scary as it is being made into.
Yeah, sir.
It's a problem. It's a huge problem, no doubt about it. But if you are cautious, if you are if you stop worrying and stay healthy physically, a lot of it impacts your mind state also. So it is manageable. It's not so difficult to stay positive in a scenario like this. It hasn't really affected my mind state per se.
Yeah.
So that's where I'm
So,
coming
but
from.
there are many people like you, even like me also, sir. We get panic, anxious. We don't know what is going to be the
Correct.
future of us or anything like that. And when we get this negative thoughts, sir, how should we balance ourselves and come back to normal, sir? What do you advise?
Okay, two things that I usually I've been interacting with students and other people also, and I've realized the problem is that they've been pushed into worrying too much. Oh, this is such a big problem. I don't know what is
Yes,
going to
sir.
happen. There are so many people getting affected. We are testing less number of people. But if you look at it, the percentage of people who are being tested versus the percentage of people who are recovering from this pandemic versus the number of people who have lost their lives, unfortunately, and it's not a good sign, but the percentage of improving people is getting higher day by day. If there are 10 people who are getting affected, 5 people will be recovering in no time. 5 people may take some time to recover. It's all about you know how things happen in the world is that I have to clear this exam anyhow. When you're a student, you are worried only about your exam. So if you're worried about your exam that I have to clear it and there is no way anybody is going to stop me, then you clear the exam. Then nobody stops you. So it's about your mind space. If you're clear that no, this is how I'm going to do it, this is how I'm going to deal with it, and not let anybody else bother me, then you are at home. Then you are anyways at home, so you can chill.
Correct, sir. Sir, but people who have to go to media, like some people who are working and they have to
Yes.
go to work, there's no choice. For them also, what kind of things they should keep in mind and how should they balance it, sir? Should they think something that will calm them down? And what do you do, sir, if such kind of situations when you get any negative thoughts? I'm sure you must be also getting negative
Absolutely.
thoughts. So when you get it, so
Simplest thing is to accept that there is a problem.
okay.
If I accept that there is a problem, then I will try and deal with it. Yes. If I've been hurt, let's say I'm playing cricket and the ball hurts me, then I know that I've been hurt. So what will I do? I will go and see a doctor, or I will probably, apply an ointment or some spray, or I will take a medicine for killing the pain and then get on with life.
Correct.
But if I
Okay,
do
sir.
not want to accept that there is a problem, then there is a bigger problem. People who are working in media, or people who've been asked to go to work, some people who have a field job, particularly in media, those who are reporters, they have to go to field and cover various locations and cover various news. In that
Yeah,
scenario, there is a possibility that they may get this depressing thought. That God knows what is going to happen, how am I going to
yeah.
survive? There is so much of a problem around. The solution to this is that first of all, you must accept that there is a problem, one, and to what, whenever you have a problem, you try and find a solution to it. You don't sit at home and let somebody else tell you that this is the solution. So this is a pandemic. It is caused because of a virus. The easy way out is that you have to build your immunity, point number one. Two, take proper precautions, use a mask, use that plastic helmet thing which is being very popular, and your gloves and all those things, and sanitize yourself, wash your hands, the basic things. Even after that, if there is a problem and you get this coronavirus entering into your body and you show signs of the signs of being ill, still do not panic. Take it easy and go and see a doctor. 9 out of 10 times the possibility are that you will get cured by taking the right medicine, taking the precautions. There is no vaccine for the virus. Several things which you can do to build your immunity, and if your immunity is strong, the virus is helpless.
Absolutely. So that's what, sir, that is the thing, because people don't think like you and everybody become panic, and that's the situation that's happening around, sir. Sir, now, we'll
No,
keep this
stop
pandemic
WhatsApp. Wait,
aside.
can I inter? I'll
Pardon,
just
sir?
interject for a moment. Please stop reading WhatsApp. Please stop reading WhatsApp forwards on coronavirus. You will be safer.
Absolutely, absolutely, sir. Bang on. This is the finest tip. I heard stop reading WhatsApp forwards and stop watching YouTube
Absolutely.
on pandemic. Sir, I just want to keep this pandemic aside and I want to ask a question. Sir, you were into media, you were long time in radio and everything and everything. Suddenly, why, sir, you went on to become a coach? And what made you to become that, sir? And what type of thought process you had when you wanted to shift yourself to this? And which is making you more happy, sir? Is it being the, you were already a coach, sir, national programming head or whatever, sir. फिर सेपरेटली आप क्यों
हाँ
सर मीडिया छोड़ के या मीडिया से थोड़ा दूर रह के, आई डोंट नो इफ यू आर कनेक्टेड और थोड़ा दूर रह के आप वाई सर दिस
हाँ
ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन?
एक्चुअली आई एम नॉट रियली अवे फ्रॉम मीडिया. आई एम जस्ट आई एम नॉट अ पार्ट ऑफ रेडियो एनी मोर. एंड द बिगेस्ट रीजन फॉर नॉट डूइंग रेडियो और यू नो स्टॉपिंग टू डू रेडियो वॉज दैट आई रियलाइज दैट आई वॉजन कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटिंग एनीथिंग टू द रेडियो फ्रेटर्निटी एट ऑल. आई वॉज जस्ट होल्डिंग अ पोजिशन एंड डूइंग वॉट एवर जॉब केम माई वे. एंड आई वॉज एक्चुअली वर्किंग एज हाउ शुड आई पुट इट. आई वॉज जस्ट वर्किंग. आई वॉज इंट रियली थिंकिंग दैट आई शुड कम अप विथ मोर आइडियाज. आई शुड कम अप विथ मोर पाथ ब्रेकिंग थिंग्स. एंड ऑल्सो बिकॉज द करंट इकोनॉमिक सिनारियो वॉज नॉट अलाउिंग अ लॉट ऑफ एक्सपेरिमेंट्स इन रेडियो. सो वेन यू आर वर्किंग इन एन ऑर्गनाइजेशन एंड यू देर इज अ पॉइंट और देर इज अ थ्रेश होल्ड दैट कम्स इन योर लाइफ वेर यू रियलाइज दैट यू आर जस्ट देयर. यू वेक अप, यू गेट रेडी, यू गो टू ऑफिस, यू कम बैक एंड देन यू स्टार्ट वॉचिंग टेलीविजन, हैव डिनर एंड गो टू स्लीप. दैट इज वेन योर ग्रोथ स्टॉप्स. एंड इफ द ग्रोथ स्टॉप्स यू यू कैन नॉट कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट टू योर ऑर्गनाइजेशन. एंड दैट्स द बिगेस्ट डिसर्विस दैट यू विल एवर डू टू एनीथिंग दैट यू आर डूइंग, वेदर इट इज योर ओन ऑर्गनाइजेशन और वेदर यू आर वर्किंग विद समबडी एल्स. सो वर्क टिल द टाइम यू आर एंजॉइंग इट, वर्क टिल द टाइम यू आर एबल टू कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट. सो दैट वॉज द स्ट्रॉन्गेस्ट रीजन वाई आई डिसाइडेड दैट आई एम नॉट एबल टू कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट रेडियो. सो आई टुक अ ब्रेक. I traveled. I met a lot of people. I met a lot of interesting people across India and outside also. And then I realized that to find the purpose of life, what is it that you really want to do, really, really, as in, you know, this is what life should be all about, is something, as you said, that I was a kind of a coach when I was working in radio and working with you. So I realized that I somehow enjoy assisting others if they are facing a challenge, if they are facing a problem, if they are having a communication issue, if they are having a personal issue, if they are having a professional issue. I enjoy helping them. So why
Correct,
not get
sir.
into a space where I can officially help them and also make some money out of it? So that was the reason why I decided to take up this profile and start doing something like this. Currently, I am helping people finding their calling. I'm trying to help people understand the challenges of their profession, understand how they should be dealing with this pandemic or otherwise. A lot of people have lost jobs. A lot of people have gone through salary cuts. So how should they deal with it? How should their lifestyle should be? I've just started consulting. In fact, this morning I started this conversation with a person who is facing challenges with his peer group. How should he deal with people who are now working from home and they're quite happy, used to it, they don't want to go back to office at all, and he's struggling to get them to come to office and make them work. So I've started consulting him on how to become a more popular person amongst your peer group and how to lead them. So these are a couple of things that I am doing. It just so happened that I enjoy helping people, assisting them, and I realize that this is something which is really interesting. all the experience that I have gained can be put to use into it, and I will also learn something from the other person. So that's the reason, no other specific reason. I'm not away from media. I'm still a very, very much a part of media. I've just started writing for News 18 Hindi website. That's something that I'm doing. I'm also trying to figure out if I can get my YouTube channel going. Everybody's doing it, so I should also do it. But let's see.
Fantastic,
It,
Raf.
it's it's gonna take a little while to do it. I want to do it on my own, and that's why it's gonna take a little while for me to crack this. So
Sir,
that's
I've
where I am.
seen fantastic, sir. I've seen all your live shows, sir, in Instagram, and also in, I think you should surely start a YouTube channel, because it will help. It will keep us, you know, if we can always rewind and just check all your shows and see all those things. So,
Correct.
yeah. So then my next question is going to be on, you know, so you were talking about how you're helping people in solving their personal issues. So
Yes.
suppose somebody is, some people are not vulnerable, like, you know, they don't like to talk to anybody. Some people don't even want to go to meet a psychiatrist, sir. In such, or a psychologist, or even a counselor.
Counselor, correct.
In such situations, people like you can really help, sir. So have you ever felt that, you know, that's the reason you have come into coaching people, or how is it, sir? What made you to transform this?
Okay, the job of a coach is not that of a psychologist or psychiatrist or a counselor. These are the people who are professionals dealing as per a course that they have done, you know, the studies that
Correct,
they
sir.
have done. My experience comes from the people that I have interacted with. So I try and understand the humane side of the problem. I try and understand the person first, and then I try and probably suggest something that he should work upon or she should work upon. And then I sit with them, as in I sit through the entire process of their transformation. I myself have been an extremely introvert as a person in the beginning. I still don't enjoy parties. I feel very claustrophobic at times, and I tend to run away from those places. But because life coaching is more about one-on-one conversations, I try and understand. There are a lot of times, and I'm sure you have gone through this in your professional career, that there are times when you just want to vent out. You know, you're really pissed with
Very
people.
true.
You're really angry with your teammates or your boss or somebody from your professional workspace, and you just want to vent out. And not because you're looking for a solution, but because you want somebody to see that what you are saying is right.
Very true,
Suppose I
sir.
have a problem with my boss, but I can't go and tell him. There are times that he will accept it, there are times that he will not accept it. In that scenario, who do I go to? So earlier we had parents, we could go to them, talk to them, and they would give us some worldly advice.
Correct, sir.
Nowadays, we have very limited interaction with parents, and as you rightly said, that people find it very awkward to go and talk to somebody about their problems. So
Correct,
in
sir.
that scenario, I'm just a friend. I'm not going to preach you anything. I'm not going to give you fancy books to read or colorful pills to take. But I'm just going to talk you through the process of how to change the place where you are. I'm going to talk you through the situation where you are in and you want to come out of it. And it's not a rocket science. It's a very simple process. It has no fancy attachments to it. It's just that
Correct,
how
sir.
much you are able to confront your own self, and then it
That's
makes my
true.
job much easier.
That's true, sir. Very true. There are many people joining us, sir. So that is, I want any, if anybody wants to ask any question, it can be on media, it can be on movies, it can be on anything related to life issues. You can ask your, even if you have any personal issues also. You can ask him, not now in the live, but yeah, you can. I will put down, I'll link his this thing after this live, his page, so you can go personally and contact and ask him. So there's many people who are watching. If any questions, please do ask. Thank you so much for your most valuable advices, Ghazal singer Riaz Khan. So yeah, many people are thanking you, sir. Of course, you can't see the comments. You can see later, sir, and answer to it. Pratima has, that's so true. We must first learn to confront ourselves. So yeah. So how do we deal with this, sir? So if as you said, you know, when we are having such, we really don't know to whom to vent out, and you know, when we approach, we don't know whether we should tell some things, we don't tell something, what the people will people judge us. So many things run around our brains, sir, when we want to really, even if I want to approach you as a life coach, sir, I don't know how much should I tell you, how much should I don't tell you, and what way will I be treated, sir, if at all I approach you as a as your client. So how is it, sir?
Okay, there are the process is very simple, as I said. Once we connect either on Facebook or phone or email, whichever way, whether you're comfortable revealing your identity or not is also up to you. You can write an email and then make me understand what you are going through. Usually, the nine out of 10 times the problems are that we are unable to express the problem. Once we
Correct.
are able to articulate what the problem is, and then we try and figure out, okay, so I'll give you a very weird example. So I consulted a person who always thought that he's not the smartest boy in the class, okay? And although he was a very well-read person, he understood because he came from a small town to a bigger town, so the obvious challenges that any small town person comes to a bigger town faces. Sometimes it's got to do with the economic scenario around, sometimes it's got to do with the kind of education that they have received. Somebody has studied in probably a government school and suddenly interacting with people who have come from a convent school. He probably listens to Sonu Nigam and Arijit Singh, and these people are listening to a Rihanna or God knows who all are singers now. So there is a divide that he faced, and that's the reason that he was feeling very underconfident. So I said, so the course of discussion with him went very simple. I asked him, so what is it that you like? So he said, sir, I like Sonu Nigam. So I said, let's sing 10 songs of Sonu Nigam that you remember. So he started singing. So four, five lines from each song. So he sang some 15, 20 songs back to back without stopping. So I said, good. Then I got another person who was a convent-educated person, although a year senior to him. So we put him on a call, and I said, so you tell me, who's your favorite artist? So he said, sir, I like Kelly Clarkson. So I said, wonderful. So can you sing five songs of Kelly Clarkson? So he said, sir, I can't sing. I know the songs. I know the title of the songs, but I can't sing the songs. I know the songs. So I said, no, no, try. Let's just one or two lines from each song that you like. He couldn't name five songs, Jyoti. He could not name five songs of his favorite artist. On the other hand, this fellow who liked Sonu Nigam could sing 20 songs of Sonu Nigam back to back. So it is a myth that people who live in big cities are more intelligent and people who come from small cities are not so intelligent. It was not a question of his belief in himself. And it was a
Correct.
very small thing that I
Absolutely,
did.
sir.
It's a quick check on your abilities. Sing 10 songs of your favorite singer and ask somebody who likes international music, sing 10 songs of your favorite singer. You will realize people who like Sonu Nigam or Arijit Singh or Chitra, they will have far more knowledge about music than somebody who likes like a Rihanna or anybody, Beyonce. So it's not about class. It was a simple thing. So people who are afraid of opening up, people who are afraid of मेरा जजमेंट तो नहीं होगा. Somebody will some this fellow, I don't know who this fellow Viplav is, and I don't know why he thinks that he'll be able to help me. I am not going to help you at all. Who am I to help you? I am somebody who is sitting outside and looking at your problems a little more objectively. That's all. So
Very
a
true, sir.
coach is like if you see, and it's a very crude example, although I'm nowhere in the class of Ramakant Acharekar sir, but Ramakant Acharekar sir was coach to Sachin Tendulkar, he was coach to Vinod Kambli, he was coach to Praveen Amre, he was coach to a lot of people from Bombay. Sachin Tendulkar made it really, really big. Vinod
Very
family
true,
started
very
off
true.
very Vinod family started off very, very well, but he didn't do very well for a long time. Praveen Amre was a consistent player in test team. He wasn't very good at test cricket. So he produced one Sachin, he produced one Kambli, he produced Praveen Amre, but he taught all three the same thing. So
Very true, very true.
why these people turned out different? Because individually Sachin wanted to excel, Kambli wanted a flashy lifestyle, Praveen Amre was a simple, sober, consistent, hard-working guy. So he became, all three of them became what they wanted to become. Ramakant Acharekar sir remained the same. So a coach never tells you what to do. A
Correct,
coach can only
absolutely.
tell you, listen, this is what you should do, or this is what you are doing wrong. That's all. So being a life coach is more about how open you are to somebody. If you are able to open up, you will realize that you will find solutions by talking to me more often than
Very
not.
Very true, sir. So that's the thing, sir. So half of your problems will be solved when you talk to people like you, sir, because the positivity or the kind of knowledge you spread is really, really very happening and very happy, sir. So I want to ask you that who inspires you, sir, as such? Do you read any particular books or any particular people you follow in your life? You want to name them?
Actually, I don't. I have nobody whom I can follow. I try.
Really?
It's not. I no. I'll tell you genuinely. Sometimes what happened. I really really tried to follow somebody. I really tried to follow a Guruji. I really tried to follow a famous author who has written great books. But then I realized that they are good in bits and pieces. They are good in part A, but not so good in part B. For part B, I have to go and see somebody else. For part C, I have to meet somebody else. So I try and not to follow anybody, because then I'll be another version of them. I will not have an individual identity. I guess in this current scenario, everybody wants to have an individual identity of their own. I don't want to follow anybody. I like a lot of people, but I like a lot of people. I like a lot of people whom I worked with. I like a lot of, including you, Jyoti, because you're the sweetest person I've ever worked with. And I'm not being bashful about it, or not because we are chatting right now. You're the sweetest person that I've worked
Thank
with.
Thank you, sir.
There are people who those who know more than me are the people I like to idolize. So if somebody knows more about marketing, I will always go and ask him about marketing. If somebody knows more about cricket, I will go and ask him. So everybody is a guru to me. So everybody is a teacher to me. So I really don't know
sir.
If I should follow one teacher or I should follow everybody. I can't follow everybody. And following just one person doesn't make sense logically. I read a lot. I read a lot of people. But that's about it. I try and pick up from everybody. That's my philosophy.
Sir, there's one question. Shall I take a question?
Please.
So how do you manage anger? So that's the best question, sir, because to you, because you never get angry, sir. How is it, sir? Really, sir, I sometimes wonder, how does that you don't even get angry, sir, that, biggest mistake we make, even in front of Tarun, you will never get angry also, and you protect yourself above all, So how is that, sir? You never get angry. We used to think, arey, humne aisa kar diya. Sir, humko baad mein aise daatenge, you will forget it also. So somebody was asking about how to manage anger. So you are the right person to tell it, sir. So how to manage anger, sir?
Okay, let me define anger for you. Anger is something when you are not in control of of the situation. Correct?
Okay.
You get angry when you are not in the control of a situation. Let's say I have a daughter and sometimes she is not into studying. And even if I tell her that, Sanika, it's time for you to study. So you should study and stop watching television or leave your mobile phone or stop chatting or Instagram and Snapchat, whatever that they do. I would ask them, don't do it now and just get back to study. She will not listen to me once, she will not listen to me twice, she will probably not listen to me the third time also. And then I cannot control the situation, I get angry. So there are two kinds of situations now. One is something that you can do something about it, and there are situations where you can't do anything about it. Like corona, you can't do anything about it. It has already come to India, it has spread, and you may get affected. There is nothing to worry even then. But there are situations where you can control. Probably you will go and switch off the Wi-Fi, and your daughter will be forced to go to her room and pick up books and start studying. So there are things that you can control. So whenever you are getting angry about anything, just take a quick moment, not too much. Can you really make a difference to the situation? Yes, then make that difference. Then ask again, can you really make a difference to the situation? No, then don't do it. Why worry? If somebody is going to jump off the cliff, you really can't stop him because you're at the bottom of the cliff. So why worry? What is the point of shouting at somebody who's on the top of the cliff and wants to jump? Nee, 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 don't jump, but he'll jump. But if you're on the cliff, and you can stop him, then you must stop him. Then you must use all your powers to stop him. So getting angry is never a solution. Getting angry is always, it will always lead you to disaster. So just think for a quick second, can I really make any change in this situation? So suppose in a party you meet an old friend who's gotten really, really drunk. You can't undo that, correct? What will you do?
Correct.
You will stay away from that friend. He's really drunk.
Very.
He's talking nonsense. Let's stay away from him or let's leave the party. Why stand
That's
there and get into a fight with him? So anger management is the easiest thing in the world. So like you said, when you were working, you would commit a mistake, and then why would I not get into an argument, or why would I not scold? Is there a point? Now you have made the mistake, no?
Very true, sir.
Can you hear me?
Light
I
has
think
gone,
so.
sir.
Yeah, there is a power
I can hear
problem
you,
in
but I
our.
can't see you, sir.
Oh, wonderful. So let's do this black and white dance for some time. Till the time
No,
it
sir.
comes back.
What happened? Well, I think there's a light gone, sir. Is that so?
Yeah, there is a power cut problem.
Pocket problem, sir.
Yeah, it'll come back in 30 seconds. Don't worry. We'll go on an
Yeah,
alternative
sure,
course.
sir. We'll finish this light. Thank you.
Yes,
Thank you for
yes, yes.
joining. We'll reconnect. There's a pocket.
No, no, don't
Thank
worry.
you.
It'll come back in 30 seconds. Just stick around.
Yeah, then we'll
See, I
hold
can't do
on, sir.
anything about this problem, no?
Yeah, sir. We'll hold on there. Meanwhile, I'll read one question, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a question asked by Pratima Jaydev. The
Yeah.
majority of youth today love taking up challenges and competitions, but they
Yes.
don't like following a process to they a process. So they start their new business or projects, but fail in midway through. In one such person comes to you, If one such person comes to you, how will you guide them or coach them?
Okay, I kind of lost the question in between. So, correct me if I'm
Yeah,
going
I'll read
wrong.
again, sir. I'll read again.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll read again, sir. The majority of youth today love taking up challenges and
Yes.
competitions, but they
Absolutely.
don't like following a process, so they start their own business or project. If one such person comes to you, how will you guide them or coach them? I think we lost you, sir.
Can you hear me now?
Sir, network issue, sir.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, now I can hear you.
Okay. You will get the video also in a bit.
Yeah.
So should I
No, we
answer the
got your
question?
video also, sir.
Okay, wonderful.
So
So,
you understood the question, sir. You want me to read again?
No, I got your question. I'm just trying to figure out how should I answer this question. There are a lot of people, especially in cities like Hyderabad, Bangalore, Bombay, where there is a lot of startup culture happening. A lot of people
Yeah.
start and get into I want to start my own business, and I will come up with an app idea. I will make an Uber of something and all of that. Those kind of dialogues you get to
Yeah,
listen to
yeah,
these days.
yeah, huh.
And then most of them do not follow the process, and it's an absolute fact. Okay, 2.7% of the world's startup ideas are successful? 93% of them are not. They flop midway. Okay.
Oh.
So if people flop, the problem that as a society we face is that we have not been taught to handle failure. We have been taught only to handle success. So if somebody gets success, we tell them, okay, don't let it go to your head, be humble, be grounded. But if somebody fails, we don't know what to do with him. Oh, he has failed. I told you, he is not a good guy. He was bound to fail. He didn't work. The problem is this,
mm-hmm.
that if somebody fails, let's accept that he fails. So what? It is not a big deal. It's not the end of life. It is not going to take away his life from him.
Very true,
he has
sir.
Failed. He started a venture. He wanted to do something on his own. He started
mm-hmm.
a business. He did not follow a
mm-hmm.
process and it stopped.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. He will go into something else. He will take another step. He will do something else and start all over again. People who learn from their mistakes and experiences are the best people to be around with. People who do not learn from their mistakes are the worst set of people. And to answer Pratima's last point that what should I do to support them or what would I do to tell them how to do it, it is that it is again my way of dealing with such situations is conversation. And see
mm-hmm.
where they have gone wrong, step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4, because a startup consists of many steps. And we can analyze and talk about so this is what the problem was, this is how I dealt with it, was I right? We'll analyze the situation, okay, this is where you went wrong probably, and you could have done this. So next time when you start
mm-hmm.
up start a new venture, don't make a mistake like
mm-hmm.
this, try and do something else. In all our professional lives, we have made mistakes. I haven't met one person who has not made a mistake in his life, including the biggest person that all of us should admire, Mahatma Gandhi. He also made mistake and he wrote about it, that these are the mistakes that I made in my life.
Very
so if he
very
can make mistakes, we are so hardly mortals. Huh? We have no right to, you know, say anything. We can let people make mistakes and learn from it.
Sure, sir. I think that's the answer. I think, Pratima, you have got your answer
in
from
case
sir.
He hasn't, he
any
can,
more questions?
Write to me.
Pardon, sir?
In case she hasn't got the answer, she can write to me. I'll be happy to answer her.
Yeah, she can write to you. You can write to him. I will link his details after the slide. Yeah. So, there is another question. So, this is from Shilpa Chakravarti. She is an anchor. How should we instill confidence in ourselves when we come constantly pushed down by others, our zeal goes down, and how to keep our mental status in that place then?
Okay. I think Shilpa, you got the right question, and this is a problem that a lot of people face, especially in the performing arts field. You are an anchor yourself, you are a performer yourself, there are chances that other people are trying to put you down, push you down and put you in a negative mental state. So how to come across as a confident person? So I'm sure, and I'll use Karela, I don't know what do you call Karela, bitter gourd, I don't know what's it called in Bengali, but bitter gourd is something that a lot of people don't like as a vegetable, right? So Karela nobody likes, but sometimes you have to eat Karela. That's point number one. Point number two, if you don't like Kerala, don't cook Kerala. If you don't like negative people, don't be around them. It's very simple. I chose not to be with people who were not being positive with me. I started it with at a very early age when I understood that if you have right set of people around you, if you have happy people around you, you yourself remain happy and you are able to deliver better. If you are crying, if you are angry, if you are frustrated, you can never deliver anything. So it becomes very important. If somebody is trying to put you down, can you change that person? Probably yes. So then change that person, have a conversation with him, tell him that, okay, this is what you are doing and I don't like it. You should not talk to me like this. But there are situations when you meet somebody who cannot be changed and don't work. Because hum log Bhagwan nahi hai na. We can't change everybody. वी हैव
नहीं सर,
टू
नहीं सर, वो ठीक है सर, लेकिन करियर में लाइक शिल्पा हर्सेल्फ इज अ पॉपुलर एंकर. जब कोई यू नो दे ट्राई टू डिग्रेड देम एंड पुल देम डाउन, दैट्स अ क्वेश्चन आई थिंक शी इज आस्किंग. और डू पॉलिटिक्स बिहाइंड देम, वैसे सिचुएशंस में अगर यू नो द शो वाज सपोज्ड टू बी होस्टेड बाय मी, बट देन दे डू सम पॉलिटिक्स एंड समबडी एल्स होस्टेड, यू नो यू लेटर ऑन नो दैट समबडी हैज प्लेड पॉलिटिक्स बिहाइंड यू. You know that kind of a
So,
situation, how do you know handle it and still move on and still constantly, how should you balance your mental state or something like that, sir?
the again I will go back to the angry situation wala answer. Can you do something about it?
No, sir, nothing.
Then why worry about it? I'm saying you have a lot of energy inside you. You have a lot of positivity inside you. Why do you want to waste it on people who do not deserve it? People who try to pull you down are somewhere down. No, there is a reason that they are down, and that is why they are trying to bring you down to their level. You are already above them. Why do you bother about such people? If
Very
you
true.
are if you are supposed to host a show and somebody else got the show, you must thank yourself that you were stopped because of the circumstances from doing a shitty show. Probably you were saved from doing a bad show. You are saved from the rowdy crowd, probably. Why worry about it? We always try and find people who are like you. Always try and find people who you really vibe with. Because although it sounds very preachy, but you always feel happy when you are with your friends. You're never happy when you're not with your friends. With random
Very
people, you
interesting.
can never be happy, right? So it's a task. It's not easy. It's not easy to find right set of people. It's not easy to fight and battle 24/7 with such kind of ne with negative people. But whether you want to deal with them or not is a choice that you can make. Nobody else can. If you don't want to deal with them, thank you very much. Bye bye. If you want to deal with them, then fight with them.
Very true, sir. Very true. Shilpa, I think your question is answered. Any more questions like this, you can contact Vipla sir. I will link his details. We'll take any more questions. Please do ask questions. I'm not taking any questions which I've already asked on angle or something like that. Please do ask any questions, sir. आप रिव्यू भी कर रहे हैं सर. आई हैव सीन यू डूइंग लॉट ऑफ रिव्यू ऑन मूवीज
यस
एंड एवरीथिंग सर. सो हाउ डिड यू डेवलप दिस इंटरेस्ट सर, एंड हाउ डू यू टेक योर टाइम, हाउ मच टाइम यू इन्वेस्ट इन यू नो डूइंग रिव्यू आइदर ऑन द सीरीज और ऑन द मूवीज, हाउ डू यू डू दैट सर?
ओके आई डू दिस सीरीज ऑन इंस्टाग्राम फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल बिकॉज आई वॉन्टेड टू डू समथिंग विद इंस्टाग्राम सो आई स्टार्टेड डूइंग इट विद इंस्टाग्राम I explored this medium. I quite liked it, and I really thought that Instagram gives you a more close audience, familiar audience to deal with. And there are people who have developed interest. They are mostly on Instagram. So what I do is on Wednesdays, like today at 8 o'clock, I will go live on Instagram and I will talk about one movie, one web series, and one book that I have read, I have
Okay.
seen. Subject like today's subject is Che Guevara. So Che Guevara was a rebel leader, was a Marxist leader, and his life is an absolutely fascinating life that you will ever find. The most rebellious leader world has ever produced, probably, as I call him. He's one of the people that I really admire in terms of tenacity and how passionate he was about the cause. So I pick one up. I try and see the movie. I try and see the web series. I books I have read most of the time. I have read the books and. That makes my job much easier while selecting the subject. I also look at my library and see if I have the book to discuss. So, assuming I have to revisit, then I reread and then I talk about it. A lot of time is invested in research. A lot of time is required for knowing about the subject and talking about things. So, yeah, but it's an interesting thing that I really like doing this now. I really think that there are people who would want to, listen to these conversations and understand and read and
Very
watch
true.
what to do or
Very
watch
true.
on something on television because most of the time when you log on to Netflix you are struggling what to watch today. You scroll through everything but you still don't get an answer most of the time. So that's the
Very true,
solution
sir.
I'm trying to build that thought here.
Very nice, sir. Sir, so you Can you recommend for us the present any of the best series to watch?
It purely depends on what you really really watch. I finished watching Patal Lok. I don't know if Hindi audience really likes
Yeah, sir,
that
a lot
kind
of
of
them
movie.
are Hindi audience only, sir.
Yeah,
So
so Patal Lok I really liked. Before that I watched Panchayat. There is a web series on, I think on Z5, not sure, but Panchayat is a very very beautifully, very well written, very neat and clean family drama that you can watch.
Very true, sir.
I have also seen Narcos. I'm sure everybody has seen Breaking Bad and all those things people have seen. I also was watching The Last Ship. I quite enjoyed season 1. I didn't enjoy season 1, so I stopped the next season. So
Okay,
season 1 ho
okay,
gaya,
okay.
utna dekh ke khush hai main. So there are things. So there are a lot of things. In fact, like today when we are going to discuss, I'm going to discuss about a movie called The Motorcycle Diaries. I think it's one of the most amazing books ever written. It's one of the most beautifully made movies about this fellow called Che Guevara. If you get a chance, either on YouTube or one of the OTTs, you will get to watch these movies. You must watch these movies, or you must watch anything about Che Guevara. There are people who have led a heroic life and they can be followed that way.
Very nice, sir. Very nice, sir. So we'll take any other questions, sir, from people. Best web series, as sir has answered. Best movies. Movies, sir?
Oh, there are a lot of them. There is no dearth of them. When I'm not too happy in terms of when I'm unable to control the situations, my go-to movie is Kill Bill. It's a very weird choice. It's an extremely violent movie, part one and part two both. But it's cathartic for me in a way. I just watch the mindless violence in the movie and then I feel
okay.
better about it. I also like
okay.
the Godfather series, part one particularly. I enjoy watching it. And whenever I'm trying to find a solution to my problem, if there is a client who has given me a problem and I can't find a solution, I go and watch Breaking Bad TV series. So I find a solution somehow
oh, wow.
in the middle
yeah,
of it.
Yes, sir. Yeah. I love it.
It
sir,
gives me a solution.
That's interesting, sir. Sir, most of the things what you told, even the Patal Lok is really very nice. Sir. Even I related to it very
yes.
much. It's a really interesting story. And even the Panchayat, you know, the best web series. And, you know, I started watching it after seeing your review on it, sir. I think you did
oh.
the, you spoke about it on, I think, few weeks ago. Yeah,
yes.
So after that day, I started to watch it, sir. It's really, really nice. So thanks for giving such kind of, knowledge on what series to watch or what not to watch or which is interesting, which is not interesting. Sir, coming back, sir, there's a lot of layoffs happening in many companies, sir, whether it is IT or whether it is media or whether it is any particular thing, sir. Now, people tend to get demotivated, many, many cases, sir, not of corona, but because of these people are doing suicide, sir. So, because they're going through a lot of stress, so what can, if a person gets like this, you know, losing their jobs or whatever happening, how should they, you know, come back to that situation that this too shall pass away is easy to say, sir, but
yeah, yeah.
how to implement it, sir?
There is no concept called it this too shall pass away. This is here to stay. So nothing passes away unless you want it to pass away. Unless you kick it really hard. We've been taught this way. Arre, achha time, bura time nahi rukega, achha time bhi nahi rukega, it will come back, all of that. It doesn't happen on its own. Point number one. Point number two, losing life is not a great idea. Although people think it's an act of cowardice, I think it's an act of bravery. Not many people have the courage to, you know, commit a suicide. And it's a very, very brave thing to do. But if that bravery can be used for destruction, why can't we use it for construction? I have counseled somebody who lost his job in the month of February. And I have told him that, okay, so you were doing this job for so long. And you were at one point you were probably the most indispensable person in the organization, but now the organization has really grown. they don't need you. You have also started slacking and you have also not been performing. So company has asked you to go. So what should you do? So he said ki, I don't know, I am confused. I want to die because I can't bear these expenses and there are bills and all of that. I said, okay, wonderful. If
Correct.
you want to die, you should. There is no, nobody is going to stop you from dying. Everybody dies at some point. But the energy that you are going to invest in thinking on about how to die, or whether should I consume poison, or whether should I use some, I should hang from the fan, or whether I should go and sleep on the railway platform. So you will invest so much of time in analyzing and doing the prep. Why don't you do something else and prep for something else completely different from what you have been doing? I asked him, what is your passion? So he said, I like photography. I said, do you really enjoy doing photography? He said, yes. I said, show me the work. Some of the pictures were good, some of the pictures were not so good. But I said, ki, so why don't you become a professional photographer?
Very true.
So he said, ki, haan, I can. Then I put him to somebody who actually does wedding photography. Nowadays, you've seen the wedding photography itself has become a big business, no? So there is a pre-wedding shoot, there is a wedding shoot, there is a lot of rituals, and then they make films out of it.
Lot of
The
stuff,
whole
very true.
jing bang. And they charge nothing less than 1 lakh rupees a day for these
Minimum, sir,
kind of shoots.
minimum.
So I said, even if you start small, even if you become a part of a 4 people gang, you will earn 25,000 rupees a month. And in four, even if you do a 4 or 5 days ka work in a month, you will earn at least 1 lakh rupees. Lakh rupees will
Easy.
at least keep you going. It may not give you luxuries, but at least it will keep you going. So he said, ki, haan, that will keep me going. So I said, why don't you do that one? So he said, but there is no wedding happening. I said, okay, I understand there is no wedding happening. What else can you do? So I said, sir, I am a Java expert, so I can teach Java. I said, so start teaching Java online. Who stops you from teaching
Very
Java
nice.
online? So he
Very
started
nice,
teaching
sir.
Java online. He lives in a society where he could gather 12 or 13 people, youngsters who wanted to learn Java. He put it on a society ka notice board. People came. Now he's teaching Java, sitting at his home, taking classes, doing, enjoying. He said, I don't venture out. There are fixed time for my classes. I do one-on-one and I do one for all class. So he's making
Very
money. I
nice.
said, the problem is that the jobs are not there. You have lost a job. There is a stop in the flow of income. Right? Now, what can you do about it? Can you cry about it or can you do something about it? If you are going to cry, then
Very
nothing
true.
will happen. So find alternative source. Now the situation is going to be that there is a reset button that has been pressed in the business also, in the world also. So we'll have to find alternative sources of income. We have to cut down the expenses and find alternative source. So I did a session on Facebook about minimalism, and I did a session on Facebook again about how to survive the pandemic. The basic thoughts were these only, that A, you can't overspend like earlier. All your clothes, fancy clothes that you bought from various malls and shopping stores, they are lying in the almirah, no? They're of no use. All those brilliant looking colorful shoes that you have, what's the use of those shoes? Nothing. They're lying in the
Sure, sir.
almirah.
Jimmy Choo, wo ye wo, something in the cupboard, sir.
They're all in cupboards. You really can't use them. So you don't really need to buy another Jimmy Choo, correct? You don't really need to buy
Correct.
another jacket from a Zara or an H&M. You don't have to go there. So you
Very
A,
true.
cut down your expense. B, try and find the other sources of income. Don't give up because अरे मैं तो जावा प्रोग्रामर हूँ, मुझे अभी जॉब कहाँ मिलेगा? उधर जॉब ही नहीं है. इट डजेंट हैपन. देर आर जॉब्स इन फील्ड्स दैट यू डू नॉट रियली एक्सपेक्ट. इफ यू ट्राई एंड फाइंड आउट योर पैशन, यू विल फाइंड आउट द जॉब ऑल्सो. इट इज़ नॉट रॉकेट साइंस. देर इज नो पॉइंट लूजिंग लाइफ, देर इज नो पॉइंट डाइंग, देर इज नो पॉइंट कमिटिंग सुसाइड. इट इज़ यूजलेस बिकॉज ऑल योर एनर्जी इज गोइंग इन टू डिस्ट्रक्शन एंड नॉट कंस्ट्रक्शन.
Very true, sir. Very true, sir. So there's another question. Present situation, which is the best business in low investment? I don't know. I don't.
No, it's a very valid question. There are people who I have advised earlier, not now, but they have advised earlier. I said, always remember, the basic premise of any life is roti kapda aur makan. Correct? The business of roti will never go out from life. Now that the restaurants are closed, there is a setback, but another 10, 15 days or a month's time, but this business will come back. So any business related to roti इज ऑलवेज गोइंग टू वर्क.
हम्म,
कपड़ा मे नॉट वर्क एट दिस पॉइंट, मकान मे नॉट वर्क एट दिस पॉइंट, बट रोटी विल ऑलवेज वर्क.
ऑलवेज वर्क,
द
वेरी ट्रू.
अदर अदर बिजनेस इज नॉलेज. द नॉलेज इकोनॉमी विल ऑलवेज वर्क, वेयर यू आर एबल टू इम्पार्ट नॉलेज टू पीपल लाइक अ ट्यूशन. एज सिंपल एज दैट, चिल्ड्रन नीड ट्यूशन. इवन इफ दे गो टू गुड स्कूल्स, दे नीड ट्यूशन. सो नॉलेज इकोनॉमी इज गोइंग टू बी अनदर बिजनेस वेर यू शुड इन्वेस्ट. इट हैज लीस्ट इन्वेस्टमेंट. पीपल कैन टीच एट होम, गेट किड्स टू कम टू होम एंड दे कैन टेक क्लासेज. एंड इट इज देर आर थाउजेंड्स ऑफ अपॉर्चुनिटीज, थाउजेंड्स ऑफ वर्क अवेलेबल, प्रोवाइडेड यू हैव टू बी ओपन टू फाइंडिंग दीज जॉब्स. इफ यू मोप अबाउट द सिचुएशन, मेरा जॉब चला गया, ओ माई गॉड वॉट टू डू नाउ, मैं क्या करूँ, it doesn't help, it doesn't help at all, it just creates more pressure on you. So pressure leke kya fayda hai life mein.
True sir. So that's the reason we had sir to talk about such situations. So we'll see any one more question sir. If any
yeah.
questions, we will take it up and then we'll wind up the show sir.
Sure.
Please do ask questions. There are many people. Thanks for joining. Sir has answered. Everybody are saying thank you so much. He
so
has
thank
answered
you.
The best web series and everything. Yeah. So true. Somebody is saying so true. Yeah. So you were talking many things, sir, about how should we balance our life and everything and everything. Now, if a situation happens, suppose if we end up getting this pandemic, sir, if me or for that matter, anybody who are watching this show, so
correct.
The first thing they get is that they are being treated like an untouchable, or, even in the society, people don't, even now, sir. They don't feel bad to say that they have got AIDS, but they are saying they feel very afraid to say that even if a relative of them have got this pandemic also, they are very afraid to say to somebody, sir. So if we get that kind of situation, we end up in that kind of situation, whether it is us or somebody in our family or somebody related to us. So how should we handle such situation? Or if we are already having it, or if we've got it, how should we mentally face it, sir?
It's a classic hate crime that we are facing currently. How people hate somebody for whatever reason, and people hate it ki, oh, this fellow has got corona, or this fellow has been diagnosed, or this family may there is a member who has got corona. So let's ostracize mm-hmm. them, let's throw them out, and let's not talk to them. And let's not welcome them, let's not enter them in their premises or you know.
Correct.
So all kinds of insults are being thrown at them, a lot of hostility towards them. So it's a classic hate crime. Hate crime so far in the world has not found a solution. We've just seen that Black Lives Matter situation has come out from US, where that George Floyd was killed. And that the elephant case that happened in Kerala or
very
the cow
best,
case,
sir.
These are all hate crimes because you cannot do anything about it. You cannot control your anger. You take it out on other people. You have a deep-rooted hatred for the other person. So what if somebody has got corona? It's a disease. You probably have got AIDS. And because of all kinds of habits, you got AIDS. What do we do about it? We have not asked you to leave the premise, no? We have not asked you to get out of the society. Having said that, hate crime has not found a solution in the world. There are things that one has not been able to explain. Like, we hate some people for whatever reason. I don't know why. We hate some people. We don't like
Very
them. Okay. And when people come up with a situation that, okay, I have got corona, but my society is not allowing. Even the workers who've been assisting, like the doctors or the nurses, they've also been ostracized by the society. So she's been serving a corona patient. She might have got the corona. She might be a transmitting agent. We will not allow her. So to make 1,000 people understand something at one go is a task. It is not going to happen overnight. People will not understand. And you should also, there is a famous saying which I use. that if there is a public in if there is a large group or if there is a public, they can be more stupid than the entire world put together. So people can be really really stupid. People can be really really nasty. Solution, I don't know if that's going to be a very very logical practical solution for the time being. Till the time you think is required, you need to shift to a place where you can survive, where you are not being ostracized, where people do not hate you because you're a corona positive patient. It's difficult. It's a time of pandemic. People have panicked. People don't know the real situation. People are clueless about a lot of things, and that's why the hate is happening. So to go to each place, everybody's place, and make them understand, and then making them कि अरे मैं ठीक हूँ, मुझे आपको कुछ नहीं होगा, मुझे घर में रहने दीजिए, दैट इज प्रॉबेबली नॉट अ प्रैक्टिकल अप्रोच.
Not, it's
इट्स वन
not
ऑफ दोज
possible, yes.
सिचुएशंस वेयर कैन यू चेंज द सिचुएशन? नो यू कांट. देन यू हैव टू चेंज योर सेल्फ. सो दैट इज वेयर द
Very
सिचुएशन
true.
इज. वी कांट हेट क्राइम्स स्टिल, मतलब इवन आफ्टर सो मेनी ईयर्स देर हैजंट बीन अ सोल्यूशन फॉर हेट क्राइम्स. वी हैव लॉस्ट द आर्ट ऑफ कंपैशन. वी हैव लॉस्ट दैट.
Very true, sir. Very
इट्स
true, sir.
डिफिकल्ट.
Very true, sir. So, we'll see any questions, sir. Many people are saying thank you. So, thank you, sir. Thank you for joining
थैंक यू
us
सो मच.
and giving us lot of information, sir. So some questions like on anger management and many things was wonderful, sir. Thank you again and again, sir, for always enlightening me and also today enlightening so many people who are watching my show. So wonderful having you, sir. And I always feel very positive and energetic the moment I see you, or even in Instagram, your shows, even in Facebook, your lives. It's so positive, sir. Thank you for always being so positive and spreading
Thank you so
positivity,
much.
sir. Thank you so much, sir.
My pleasure. My pleasure. After a long time, we have connected. I in fact wrote that Telugu line also so that I could use that, but then I realized that my pronunciations are all over the place. So
Sir,
I
please, sir,
didn't
chappandi, sir, tell us, sir.
look. No, I don't. I've written it somewhere, but now I think if I use it, my pronunciation will just make it worse. But thank you so much, Jyoti, for calling me. It's been a great pleasure. It's been an honor to interact with you after such a long time. You're the
Thank you,
sweetest
sir.
person
Thank you, sir.
I've always said you're the sweetest person I've worked with. Thank you so much.
Sure, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye.